Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. My name is Lian Duan and I have developed for 20 years, specializing in DevOps and cloud security. Today we are going to talk about how to trigger Gitlab pipeline when we merge our code in two ways. There are three main topics we'll cover today. Use Gitlab built-in value trigger pipeline. The built-in value is CI pipeline source. We'll discuss the advantage of the triggering a pipeline after merging. This is like a safety net for our code change that ensures that our code doesn't broken what's already working. I'll walk with you through the steps which use CI pipeline source in jobs rule and the workflow rule, so you can see exactly how all this works in action. Video related to markdown and the pipeline files are in my Gitlab page. The links are below. Now let's start with first topic. Use Gitlab built-in value trigger pipeline. We have a Gitlab built-in parameter called CI pipeline source. What is the CI pipeline source? When we are working on our code, different things happen, like different events. Merge request is like politely asking the pipeline to start a job with our change. We use CI pipeline source EQ merge request event to start the build in that scenario. Push to repository branch. This is when we add new code to our project, like build a new part of it. That's when we use CI pipeline source EQ to push. Scheduled pipeline. Sometimes we plan to run the job at specific time, like setting an alarm. We use CI pipeline source EQ to schedule. Manual run. It's like using a special protocol to start pipeline jobs. When we use Gitlab web interface or an API to trigger our pipeline, we see, let's make the build happen. The CI pipeline source equal to web or API for that. So the merge request event help us detect when we use Gitlab triggered build. It's like I have different buttons for different jobs. Now we are ready to pick up the right button for the right task. Why it is important? When we merge our code, we want to make sure it wouldn't broken anything. That's why we want to test it earlier it happened to us. It helps us check if everything's okay, make sure the new code doesn't mess up any old code, ensure that our code is in high quality. In our hands-on demo demonstration, we are going to learn how to set up a merge trigger rule in Gitlab pipeline. We'll make sure that the build and the test job are triggered when we merge code from a feature branch to a release branch. But before we get started, there are a few things you are need. You need a free Gitlab account. Create a project in your Gitlab account. To save our time, we'll use pipeline files from my video using Gitlab CI/CD workflow. Once everything is ready, we'll move on to first demo. Add the merge rule into jobs. This is a simple way. You can get the original pipeline YAML files right here. Gitlab CI original.yaml. Next, use it simple. Just add CI pipeline source equal to merge request event in the rules under the build job. Also, we do the same thing. Add the built-in parameter in the test job. To see the magic things happen, we have to create a merge request. To see your changes work, you will need to create a merge request in your project. Let me show you how to do it. Open your Gitlab project. In the left side navigation menu, select merge request. Click new merge request. Source branch is feature branch. Name is feature Jira 666. Target branch is release branch 20-10-1. Continue. The description is demo testing. Just send it to me. Review is me. Because is there only one count in my demo project. Create a merge request. Approve. You'll see the pipeline is running. Close the merge request. And select the pipelines in navigation menu. Open the status to see the detail. there are two jobs running. One is build, other is test. That's match or trigger the job rule. You can add the CI pipeline source into the workflow to do the same thing. Let's back to the markdown file. Move to latest topic for today. There's already no git YAML file right here. GitLab CI workflow.yaml. If you're interested in the video using GitLab CI CD workflow has a detail of the file. For the second demo, we'll make it a little more interesting. We're going to add the rule that beginning of the workflow and it work like this. Add the merge rule as first rule in the workflow because workflow rules are evaluated from top to bottom and the first matching rule is applied. This rule triggered when merge request event occurs and the source branch is not main branch. It means that whenever something creates a merge request to the merge code into a branch another than main branch, the pipeline will set run all build to true. Let's verify it. Open the .gitlab-ci.yaml file. Highlight the highlighted content. Commit by change. There is a conflict. Open the GitLab window to fix the conflict. The conflict is auto-fixed. Open the file and check the auto-merge result. It looks good. Commit the change and back to the GitLab page. Create a second merge request for a demo. Change the branches from feature branch to release branch. Continue. Send it to me. Reveal is me. Create a merge request. Open the pipeline ID to see the detail. There should be two jobs, build and test. This shows us add the trigger rule into the workflow successfully. That's our today's video. Today we learned how to use CI pipeline source to trigger build job when code merge happened. Thank you and see you in the next video.